Hello, you're watching Proactive London. I'm joined by Andrew Duxbury, the Finance Director at Galliford Try. Andrew, very good to speak with you today.
Yeah, morning, Stephen.
So, Andrew, we're looking at your half-year results, but first, can you remind us about Galliford Try for those who may not already know you?
Of course, yeah, we're a leading UK construction company delivering profitable, predictable, growing results for our shareholders. We operate across the UK from Inverness down to Plymouth, delivering social and economic infrastructure, so schools, hospitals, roads, water treatment works, and so on and so forth. And what that means, Stephen, we'll come on to it later, that means those sectors that we operate in are not cyclical. We have really good, sustainable growth opportunities in all of those sectors.
So as mentioned, you've released your half-year results. Could you share the highlights for us, please?
Yeah, we're really pleased with the first half-year, which ended in December 2023. Really strong performance, showing increased revenue, increased divisional operating margin, increased profit before tax, and increased dividends for the interim as well. So that's really good. There's a really good momentum in the business at the moment, driven by excellent people, excellent supply chain. So across all parts of our business have contributed to that excellent first half year results. And what we're looking to do is to deliver long-term sustainable value for our shareholders. That's our strategy, and we're making really good progress against the strategy. And that's formed off a bedrock of strong risk management, discipline, contract selection, and contract operation. That really underpins the performance. So maybe just give you a little bit more detail, Stephen, on the results. So revenue up 21% compared to the first half last year. We delivered a 2.5% divisional operating margin. That's up from 2.3% at the same period last year. And that's improvements in both our building and infrastructure divisions. We delivered a 33% increase in profit before tax and a 50% increase in earnings per share. And altogether, that meant we've delivered a 33% increase to 4 pence per share interim dividend.
Andrew, the outlook remains very positive for another strong performance in full year 24, with increased order book and also revenue visibility. What gives you confidence in your financial performance in the current economic climate, particularly with an election looming?
Yeah, well, look, we are confident for the full year to June 2024 and through to 2026, our current strategic period. I think what we've seen is the macroeconomic challenges of inflation and materials availability have eased. So that's very helpful. And we're also really confident the sectors that we operate in, they're not cyclical. They're not, you know, this largely public sector, regulated sector, but they are the kind of sectors and the sorts of projects. Our average contract size in building is less than £20 million. So it's the sort of projects which will carry on regardless of who's in government. And importantly, Stephen, our order book sees us well beyond the general election cycle. So we've got already 98% visibility for the year to June 2024. And we've got good visibility to June 2025 and indeed June 2026 as well. And that's through a really high quality order book, £3.7 billion. So a really good level of revenue visibility that sees us through that general election cycle.
Andrew, you said the sectors you operate aren't cyclical. Is your growth one particular division or is it across the board?
Yeah, so in the first half year, that growth has been across the board. So growth in our building business, which delivers things like, I say, schools, hospitals, commercial offices, and also growth in our infrastructure business, which delivers water, clean water, wastewater treatment works, and highways projects. So the growth is in both those main divisions, which is great. Maybe just to give you some examples of some contracts that we've won in the period as well. So in building, we've been appointed to a £3.2 billion affordable housing framework, the Communities and Affordable Investment Consortium. So that's a really good opportunity for our building business going forwards. In our environment business, we completed in November the acquisition of AVRS, which brings additional capabilities in the mechanical and electrical part of our water business, capital maintenance, part of our water business. And in highways, we've been appointed onto the Generation 5 civil engineering framework, which runs through to 2028. So really good contract wins across, you know, as well in each part of the business.
You've announced that you'll be updating your strategy at a capital markets event in May. What should investors expect to hear at that event, Andrew?
Yeah, so, you know, this comes on the back of, we issued our current strategy in 2021. We've made really good progress over the last 3 years, and we're confident of continuing that performance, you know, built on a strong balance sheet, you know, strong disciplines and risk management that we've talked about. So what we're looking to do in May is to update those that strategy through to 2030. And what that will be really is an evolution of the current strategy. So the investors should expect to see how we'll continue to deliver growth beyond 2026 and through to 2030.
Andrew, finally, can you maybe summarize the investment case for the business?
Yeah, of course. Well, look, first and foremost, there's really good momentum in the business, really confident. And you see that across all parts of the business when I go out and see people across the business. As we've said, we operate in non-cyclical cycles, which have got really robust markets and really good opportunities going forwards. As a result of that, the order book is really strong, and that gives us really good visibility for the future. And all of that is underpinned by really good people with the right culture and the right values to deliver that sustainable growth strategy. So in essence, that's the investment case for the business.
Andrew, thank you very much for speaking with us today. Look forward to the next conversation.
Thanks very much indeed, Stephen.
Andrew Duxbury, Finance Director at Galliford Try.